everyone, it's Snipesy and welcome back to some more Starish and The Last Hope International. We're going to keep on heading through the facility because we need to get the hell out of here and find Miracle.
Stay away, you!
We'll take care of this. Just stay where you are.
Come on, let's do it. Right, so we are fighting this Genomonic beast. Let's find out what its weaknesses are. Thunder, and it has no guard status. All right. Has a lot of health as well. Let's hide from that thing. It's an interesting beast since it has like a combination of body parts from different monsters and animals and things like that. Like a scorpion tail, an eagle arm, a snake arm, bat wings, a bull head thing. I'm not sure about the legs. It's always a bit interesting. Right, I think it's time for a bit of rush combos. So I'm gonna build it up with Edge. Oh nice! We got the blind side. Well, that got it going up quite a lot. Alright, let's do this. This might be able to take him out as well. Stampede Slash. Oh, nice. Get him, doggy. Oh, nice. Got a perfect combo. Okay, it wasn't quite enough to take him down, but we did a lot of damage nonetheless. There we go.
Alright, nice job.
And we got Iron Claws as well.
Now that's what I'm talking about!
Useful experience indeed.
This feels pretty good, eh?
Oh, we got Lightning Blast. And a lot of trophies. We could have done with that symbology a lot sooner though for the Cardinon ship, really.
Are you alright? Miracle?
That was for rescuing me. Sorry for getting spooked and running off. My name is Miracle Shamot. Who are you?
Edge Maverick.
I'm Lim.
Bacchus D-79.
My name is Faye Shifa Baleth.
That tickles, Kay.
That was also for rescuing me.
Meow.
Just my imagination? Why do you all smell like the professor?
The professor? You mean Klaus, right?
Yeah. Oh, you must be the professor's friend. Is he doing okay?
Well, actually, Klaus asked us to take you back to your home planet.
We're extraterrestrials too. You can trust us.
Like he said, come with us.
I don't even know what planet I'm from.
You don't know what planet you were born on?
Nope. The first thing I can remember is being on a spaceship I'd never seen before.
Wait. So you mean you were stowing away then?
That's what they seem to think. But they were all so nice to me. But then... we got sucked into a black hole and the ship was totaled. They pushed me into an escape pod and I survived. They all helped me get out of there before even thinking about their own safety. They were all such good people.
Mary.
Anyway, do you know if the professor's here?
Mr. Bakhtine brought us inside this base. However, we parted ways with him on the way here.
I imagine he's still inside the base.
Then take the professor into space with you, too!
Take Klaus?
I got caught when my escape pod crashed on this planet. They locked me up and did all kinds of experiments on me. But the professor was nice to me, so I don't want to leave him here.
Well, what do you think we should do, Edge?
Well, I can't make a decision for Klaus. We'll have to find out what he wants. Anyway, Raimi is priority one right now. We have to save her.
If you're looking for someone, let me help you. You helped me after all.
Huh? No, you don't
have... Let's go! Meow!
Meow.
Alright, so Miracle has now joined the party. Meowtastic. Let's grab this item. Box. Chest. Thing. Alright, so we got an alien's robe. Also, whilst I'm at it, I can do a quick rundown of our new party member, Miracle. So she has naturally a high amount of attack as well as hit. However, she has very low intelligence. But her guard's weak as well, but her defense isn't bad, and she has minimal sort of health really. She's a very fast attacker, and she's good at like hitting enemies. Like, as in projecting hits, she's really good at that, really. And she is a strike for beat, so we're gonna leave that there. Battle config. She knows Comet Impact, Ripper Pounce, and she doesn't have any battle skills at the moment. And I don't think we have anything for her, but we can see if we can equip some things. So we got the Iron Claws that we got off that weird creature. I'll give her the Silver Amulet. And for wrist defense. Or I could do that. How much health does she have? Not that much. I'll equip the silver bangle for now. Solid protector. Oh, that has a lot of defense, to be fair. I think I'm going to change the HP boost for Limmel, because I think she'll be fine without it now. Yeah, her health isn't that bad. Miracle's level 22 as well. And I'm gonna give her a boost in some of these skills. Go for crafting. That's 6. And, fee for them. Okay, that will do. I'm gonna leave some points off with what she has now because I need to give her some like skill manuals and stuff.
The Kalnis?
They must have brought it in while we were on our way here.
Their transportation technology is actually quite impressive.
Stop! Who told you to point guns at them? I am the chief director of this base. My name is Mila Bakhtine. Welcome to our planet, friends from the stars.
So you're the one in charge of this operation, then?
Yes. I hope you will forgive my subordinate's disrespect.
Huh? No, likewise.
Edge, did you hear what she said? She just called herself Bakhtine.
Are you...
Yes. Klaus is my husband. Or rather, he was my husband. Foolish sentimentality kept me from changing my last name.
This could be difficult.
Yeah.
What's wrong, Mary?
I don't like that woman!
I don't blame you for hating me. I'm not asking you to understand, but I had no choice.
You had no choice? What do you mean by that? We fought a lot of monsters to get here. You people call them test subjects. And this girl, Miracle, she tells me you kept her locked up and that you did work on her too. You made the decisions. You had a choice.
I understand that my work here might be considered inhumane. The guilt was what pushed Klaus to leave this place. But unfortunately, I have crossed the point of no return. There is something I must protect, no matter how much shame it brings me.
And what's that? Your professional name?
Certainly not! I must protect our planet Earth. The situation on our Earth is very different from the future you hail from. Our energy is nearly depleted. In fact, it may not even last for more than a few years.
Wait a minute! You just said the future!
Despite the uniform, I am a scientist. Such a deduction is not beyond my means. Though I must admit, Miss Sayanji's information was the key to making that deduction.
What have you done with Raimi? Is she safe?
I assure you, I have not harmed her in any way. She seemed rather exhausted from her ordeal, so I've given her a room to rest in.
I see.
If you will allow me to continue. To solve the looming energy crisis, our world has its eyes on a certain type of energy. The most powerful force known to man. If you're from the future, I'm sure you know what that is.
The most powerful energy in 1957. Nuclear!
Exactly. But what will come of relying on an energy source that could destroy the world? That's why I'm here. I seek a safer, more complete source of energy. I research extraterrestrial technology for the sake of that ideal.
That may be, but I cannot agree with your methods.
Yes, I understand. However, for the people of Earth, and for the sake of all those yet unborn.
Wait, are you?
The world in which you come from surely must have surmounted its energy problems long ago. Indeed, I am sure the people of your time live upon their Earth in perfect harmony. The people of this Earth need extraterrestrial technology. an energy source so perfect, it brings with it no pollution.
A non-polluting energy source? What if, and I stress if, what if you had that power right now? Would this planet...
If we had that power, the planet would surely remain blue forever. That is what I and everyone else here wish for.
You're saying we could change the future?
Edge?
You're saying the Earth could stay blue, stay beautiful.
Absolutely. If you would but help us.
Supposing we can never get back to our own Earth. If we could make a better future.
Yes, a beautiful future.
All right, what do we have to do? How can we save this planet? How can we save this planet's future?
Mr. Edge, do you understand what it could mean to alter the course of the future?
History could end up changing completely. Edge, this could affect you directly.
And it's not just you. Something may happen to Miss Raimi as well.
I know! But I also know what happens to Earth. My Earth. With its uninhabitable surface. That broken Earth is my home. And even if I could never go back there, this is the least I could do.
Edge.
Your ship, the Calnus, right? It's quite a wonderful vessel. I'm going to be as direct as I can. Will you allow me to analyze its control core?
Control core?
She must mean the exolithium crystal. It's true. They're an absolute necessity for the generation of mass energy.
Promise me this. You have to stop your inhumane research on extraterrestrials. If you encounter any more, you have to promise to work together with them. And most importantly, I need your word that you'll do nothing to contaminate this beautiful planet.
I wouldn't have it any other way. That is the very goal of our research.
We can trust you, right?
Thank you very much.
Ready the equipment. We will begin experiments immediately.
Ma'am!
Please, come with me.
What's in here?
Please, feel free to relax in here, along with Miss Sionji.
Raimi, she's inside?
Come, step inside.
Mila! What did you do to her? No way! Mila! What are you doing?
Like I said before, I have not harmed Miss Sionji in any way. All I did was calm her down a bit, and she told me so many interesting things. For instance, Mr. Maverick, I learned that you and your crew came from the future. and about your antimatter engine.
You tricked us!
That's not a very gentlemanly way to put it. If my experiments are successful, everything will be within our country's grasp. There will be no more need for inhumane research.
What?
Of course we'll be happy to work together with those from other worlds. As their rightful rulers, we will rule them, and they will serve us. And rest assured, this planet will not be contaminated. We will no longer need to damage the Earth in order to destroy our enemies.
No. Why? That's...
That looks like very bad news.
Hey, what is that thing?
It's an antimatter reactor.
They're normally used with exolithium crystals to control pair annihilation, thus
producing tremendous amounts of energy.
But that reactor is far too crude and primitive to function properly. Proper control of the pair annihilation will be impossible. An overload is inevitable.
Well, aren't we being tart? I'd appreciate it if you didn't underestimate me. I built the ultimate system together with Klaus. And we are the brightest minds of the century! Yes, and our precious son is just the same. Ah, Kevin. Our beautiful, beautiful Kevin. Mother is going to breathe new life into you now. And don't worry, I'm sure your father will join us. I can hear you! I can hear your first cry! My beautiful son!
She's insane. She's been insane. All along.
What are we to do, Mr. Edge? If the reactor overloads, it will be the end of us all.
What am I supposed to do?
Well, we're in a bit of a dilemma here, aren't we? I gotta say though, that bitch is crazy. She cray cray. Absolute cray cray. I hate this sound. It just keeps on pounding and pounding. I will investigate potential routes of escape. Please see to Miss Sionji. Miss Rainmi. Even though her surname is Sionji. Professor, I'm scared. Rainmi. Wake up.
Rainmi, thank God!
What happened? That's right! I was captured and then they...
Rainmi, no! I didn't mean to!
Edge! You perv! So all that happened while I was out?
Even if we were able to stop the reactor... It's too late now. There's going to be a massive pair annihilation.
What's going to happen to us?
The pair annihilation will reduce this base, no, the entire planet, to nothing more than formless energy.
Isn't there anything? Anything we can do to stop it?
It's too late. We have no hands left to play.
They opened it themselves. A Pandora's box they have no hope of closing.
It's not a box they could have opened alone. I let them open it. I gave them the key. It's all my fault!
No! Edge, you did it because you wanted to save the future!
That's no excuse at all!
Look at what I've done! The Earth is going to be destroyed! It's all my fault!
Edge, this is not the time nor the place for you to be talking like that.
FaZe.
You have a duty to perform. Don't leave it unfulfilled.
You have to make a decision, Mr. Edge. Not as a guilty man, but as a captain. Our captain.
Bacchus. We have to leave this place now. We have to get the hell off this planet.
Right, so now we have Raimi back in the party now, since she is fully clothed. Don't be like this, Edge. You don't have to keep berating yourself so much. This wall is strong enough to withstand a nuclear blast. Destroying it is out of the question. We will need to find an alternate plan of action. It was my fault. If I'd only realized that was a reactor sooner. Let's see what Limmel has to say. I'm alright, Edgy. You and Ray are everyone are here, so I'm just fine. Good to hear. Right, let's talk to Miracle. Huh? What's that sound?
I knew it. It's the sound of my ocarina.
I don't hear anything. Kay?
No. I know that sound. I gave it to the professor! The wall! Check it out, everyone!
Hmm? Is that?
If we follow this walkway, we should be able to reach the Kalnus.
Professor, where are you?
I'm here, Miracle.
Professor!
Miracle, I'm glad you're safe, and I'm happy to see you well.
Professor, you look like you've lost some weight.
Oh?
Professor?
Miracle, return to space. Return to space with your new friends.
If I'm going, I'm going with you.
I can't, Miracle. It's Mila. There's something I have to tell her.
Professor? Wait! Professor!
Oh, Kevin. Klaus.
Professor! Professor!
Miracle, we have to go. We have to run! We have to go!
Oh, Kevin. Klaus?
That's enough, Mila. Please, understand. Kevin wasn't your fault.
I'm sorry I left you when you were in such pain. But we both know our son wouldn't have wanted this. Let's make that boy's dream a reality. Let's work towards friendship with all extraterrestrials. And let's do it through our own abilities, not through technology beyond our means.
Yes, that sounds wonderful, Klaus. I'm sure that would make him happy.
Come on, people, hurry! Professor! Right. Let's check out this item box. Or chest. File snaps. Ooh, handy. So, these... Hang on. That's it. Minus 20% intelligence, plus 25 fall. We'll give that to Miracle, because she doesn't need intelligence, since she doesn't use she doesn't use symbology or anything. Right, I want to switch things about. Yeah, so I want to tactics. Yeah, there we go. Then we are ready. And we got a plasma cannon. And I believe that is for Bacchus. Yep, add the Sphender element to attack. Also, I got the alien arc, but that was only for Raimi, because I knew at the time that I couldn't use it. So, yeah, that's what that can be used for. Yeah, and that's weaker than what we currently have. Is it still that? Oh, it's the Cardinal Sword. Right, that's all good. Can I get in a battle with you two? No? Alright, here we go. Preemptive strike. Now, let's play as Miracle. Come here. What I really like about Miracle is like how quickly she moves with her attacks. Like, she's very agile and swift. It's very good for like taking out enemies quickly, really. Like with lots of hits. I like his skills as well, to be fair. Oh, nice. Wow! Yeah. And she has one of the best single hit moves ever. Like, it is so strong. The amount of trophies you can get off them is ridiculous. Bam boom! Yeah, she does a lot of hits. Like, that's her main trait about her fighting style.
I'm so glad everyone's safe.
Alright, we got some trophies. And she's not interested in speaking at the moment, obviously, considering the circumstances. Oh, zombie and alien. Yeah. Oh dear. I just walked right into you. Soar into the sky. Oops. Too soon. Oh well.
wonderful. I'm so glad everyone's...
Yeah, Edge doesn't feel like talking either. Right, let's get rid of some of these fresh sage. And then open that chest again. There we go. Come on, alien. I really shouldn't be fighting these enemies, but why not? Considering, like, we're gonna die. We don't. Come on, Miracle. Soar in the sky. She has some good moves to like move around as well. Like later on you can get some special arts where she can like move across places whilst she attacks, which is pretty handy really. See if we can... Nah, they're too far away. We're just gonna run for it. Why not?
An exolithium crystal. We can't escape this gravitational field with our normal engines.
No, we made it this far.
Is this the end?
Just wait a little longer, Miracle. I'm going to get you back home, to space.
But you'd be lonely if I left, wouldn't you, Professor? After all, you don't have many friends. So, here, Professor. Whenever you get lonely, you can use it to remember me, okay?
Well, then let me give you this in return.
Wow, wow! It's such a pretty pendant!
Let it guide your way into space. One day, I'm sure it will be of use to you.
Hey! You don't think this would help, do you?
What do you expect us to do with a pendant? Wait! It can't be! Where did you get such a high density? Yes, with this we could...
Edge, make preparations for warp!
But we have one! An extremely high-density exolithium crystal! I've never seen anything like it!
Warp engines, online! We can leave on your order!
Amazing! I've never seen this kind of power!
How fascinating. I'd certainly like to study this in detail when we have time.
Thank you, Professor. Come on! Let's take off!
Edgy.
Kalnis, engage!
Coordinates, star systems, I've cross-referenced 147 categories of data. There's no question we've returned to the time period we originally came from. We managed to make it home.
This is mere speculation, but the spatial collapse may have served to thrust us back to the time from which we came. Unfortunately, I cannot be certain. To speculate further, we extraterrestrials are one thing, but given the fact that you two Earthlings have not vanished from existence, perhaps that planet existed in a different dimension, an alternate Earth that was not your own.
That would mean...
I saw it. Just before we entered subspace, Earth twisted and disappeared in a flash of light. 4.6 billion years. After having miraculously survived for 4.6 billion years, it was annihilated in a single instant. Just like that. So simply.
A pair annihilation overload cannot be stopped. Nobody could have prevented what happened.
Oh yeah? You know how it could have been prevented? If I hadn't started it in the first place!
No, Edge, that's not true!
Edgy.
Edge, you did your best!
Don't try to console me, dammit! Who cares if it wasn't our Earth? It doesn't even matter. It's gone. Either way, you get it? It's all gone forever! My bad judgment pushed those people over the edge! The Earth was annihilated! Every last speck! Everything! Everything! People, children, animals, towns and houses and everything! 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 Everything!
Edgy, please stop. Stop, Kay.
I didn't go into space for this. I went for mankind's future. It's happiness. Damn it all!
Mr. Edge, the responsibility isn't yours alone. All of us were at fault here.
Yes, Bacchus is right. None of us were able to prevent this from happening. Please, Edge.
If I hadn't been there... If I hadn't handed over our technology!
Edge, if you really mean that, then what about me? I finally made some new friends. You asked me to come with you, but...
Mary...
I think that Edgy's really losing the plot here, isn't he? Anyways, let's put Raimi back with Edge. Let's see if Lim will go. Nope. Yeah, they can. Yeah, let's leave it at that. Okay. Let's try and talk to everyone. Mr. Edge, we are unable to return to our original course with the present state of our ship. We need to begin considering an alternate plan of action. Mr. Edge? Yeah. You saved Miracle, Edge. You saved all of us. That's never going to change. Edge. Don't be so gloomy, Edge. As far as we're concerned, you made the right choice back there. How come you've been so down, Edge? Mary was like that earlier too. I don't like it when everyone's sad, okay? Come on, Edge, back up. I mean, look at me, I'm feeling right as rain. Lim's really helped me feel better about all this. All of you guys have been treating me so kindly. Everything's just peachy keen. Yeah. So what are we gonna do now? Since we can't really do much. What are we gonna do? Mr. Edge, the warp engines are currently in a state of overflow. We cannot warp at this time. I believe it best to land on the nearby planet of Roke for maintenance. Will that be satisfactory? Alright.
I've entered the coordinates for our course to Roke. Mr. Edge, we can leave on your order. Mr. Edge?
Kalnus, departing for Roke. Engage, please.
Right.
Yee-hoo! How's it going, folks? Welch Vineyard at your service. Yeah? Who the heck?
Hi there, Welchy. You're all 2D today.
Hi, you're so pipsqueak, looking cute as always. Oh? What? What's this? I turn around for a minute and now you've got a cat? And not just any cat, apparently. I mean, look at those ears. Yeah, I feel like I just walked into an anime convention. What the heck is she talking about?
This is just how well she is, Kay.
Welch, right? You got that right, sister! So how have you all been? I've been trying to get through to you guys forever!
You couldn't get through to us?
Yeah! Where'd you all run off to anyway? Huh? Wait a second! Don't tell me! Are you and Edge getting all cozy with each other behind my back? Now, now, now! You two should know better than to keep secrets from Auntie Welch! Come on, spill the beans! I want every juicy detail! Like, how'd you get past the whole childhood friend thing? Huh? Wait! Don't tell me!
Sorry, Welch, we're kind of busy right now. Talk to you later. If Welch contacted us, that means...
Yes. Bacchus's hypothesis was correct. It would seem we were in a different dimension after all.
Your homeworld has not been destroyed. In this universe, your Earth still exists.
Did you hear that, Edge? Earth is... our Earth! It's safe!
Is that supposed to make me feel better?
What?
It doesn't change the fact that the other Earth was destroyed. It doesn't change the fact that I destroyed it.
Edge.
Billions of people have died, but you're all happy because we're safe? That makes us no better than the Cardianon.
That was... look, it couldn't have been helped.
If only I hadn't handed over the Exolithium crystal...
How can you continue to go on like this?
Stop it, both of you. I know how you feel. My immaturity once caused me to lose much while I was attempting to fulfill my duty as a Morphus. I have experienced much agony and regret, and yet I have never found a complete answer. But I live with the belief that one day I will find that answer. Mr. Edge, you may have much worry and regret, but keep moving forward nonetheless. If you let it hold you back, you will simply molder away.
The ship! We're under attack!
Attack? But why would anybody...
Forgive me, Miss Raimi. I'm afraid to say... I was somewhat careless.
Putting it up now!
FaZe, can you check their ship's registry?
They're... not registered! It's not from Earth or from Eldar.
I'm detecting a strong energy burst. We can't dodge it! What's that?
That ship. It's from the 13th Independent Armored Division. An Eldarian vessel.
You're those civilians from back on Eos, aren't you?
Hey, he's that... you have our thanks for rescuing us.
I'm only chasing my prey. If you get in the way, I'll shoot you down, too. Stay out of this if you value your lives, amateurs.
Well, pleasant, if nothing less.
I wouldn't take it personally. The 13th Independent Armored Division aren't exactly known for their kindness.
But still, what do you think that black ship was?
That I cannot say, but I can say what we must do next. Damage may be light, but nevertheless we have sustained an attack. We must check the ship and perform maintenance.
I suppose that gives us another reason to land on Roke. Are we able to navigate?
The attack produced a slight alteration in our course, but it should be easy enough to correct.
Please take care of it. Very well. Let us continue toward Planet Roke.
Preparations for landing on Roke complete. Your orders, Captain. Edge, your orders.
I judge the Captain to be unfit for command, and hereby exercise my rights as second-ranking officer. Henceforth, I assume command of the Calnus as acting Captain. Are there any objections?
I don't object, but do we really have to land on Roke?
Our reasons for landing are all valid.
Bacchus, if you will.
Our new exolithium crystal is putting too much stress on the ship's generators. It will take no small amount of time to recalculate our energy conversion matrix. Upon landing, we must put the ship's systems into sleep mode to complete the recalculation as quickly as possible.
And don't forget checking the ship and performing maintenance duties.
And above all, our original SRF mission takes utmost precedence. Investigating habitable planets is the reason we began our journey in the first place.
But
that is all. Begin the landing sequence.
So, this is Roke. Yes, its civilization level is, well, by Earth standards, it would be roughly equivalent to the Middle Ages. Naturally, our level of technology would be an impossibility here. I don't want to interfere with anyone. Yes, Mr. Edge. For that reason, I have installed optical camouflage devices on the Calnus and hidden it from sight. I will camouflage myself as well. Yes, please. Well then, let's start looking around. Okay, so before we do actually start looking around in Roke and stuff, I'm going to leave it off right here, since so much has happened from the previous episode. I mean, our planet has just been erased from existence. Like, that is crazy. But anyways, I hope to see you next time on another part of Star Ocean The Last Hope International, and hopefully it'll be just as epic as this one. And don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe, all that good stuff, you know it. And I will see you on the next part. Bye for now.